put aside every situation. We want to put aside every doubt. We want to drop down every weight that we have been carrying. Every concern that is bothering us in our home life. We want to give it all to him right now. We want to give it all to him right now. Every situation that we ain't got no control over in our lives, and we done tried to fix it, and we done tried to make it right, we want to give it to him. We want to give him everything that we have right now, every title we ever worn. Huh? We want to put down that pride and even that attitude. We want to just throw it all down right now. Any position that we ever even acquired.
Yes, God.
We want to put it down right now.
Thank you, Lord God.
We want to throw it at his feet right now. We want to empty ourselves to God right now.
Yes, God. Thank you, Lord God.
We want to empty ourselves that we may be able to get to that place just to reverence him and exalt him, placing nothing and nobody before him. Oh, we want to give it to him right now. We want to give him all our past hurts, our current hurts. We want to give it all to him right now. And we want to reverence him with the gratitude and the obedience that he deserves. Oh, I need an uncle see ya. We want to cry out to him right now. We want to let him know that we can't fix the unfixable. We want to let him know that he's the only one and we need you, God.
My God.
Oh, just tell him you need him.
Yes, God.
Tell him you need him over that money.
Yes, God. Thank you, Lord God.
Tell him you need him over that car.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Tell him you need him over that man.
My God. Jesus.
You need him over that woman.
Yes, God.
Let him know. But you can only tell him if you mean it.
My God.
I need you, God. Oh, God, we need you, God.
Yes, God.
We need you to touch that situation, God.
Help us, God.
We need you to fix it, God.
Yes, God.
Oh, God.
Yes, God.
We need you to come in, Father God.
Jesus.
We need you to come in right now, Father. Because we empty out ourselves to you right now, God.
Yes, God.
We empty out everything, Father God, that's causing us to be cloudy or even distracted.
Yes, God.
We empty it out to Sunday.
They didn't say it.
Oh, God.
Jesus.
We giving it all to you, God.
Thank you, Lord God.
We giving it to you, Father God, that you may stabilize some things. Because you ain't got it together, says God.
My God.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Jesus.
We pouring it out to you. We reverence you right now, Father God. We lift you up. And we look into the hills from which cometh thy help. Our help coming from you, God. You're the one that made the heaven and earth, God. You're the one that made us, God. And you created us just to worship you, God. And we're not going to allow anything to keep us, God, from worshiping you with the fruit of our lips.
Yes, God.
It's our job. Oh, God, we're not going to allow anything
Thank you, Lord God.
To hinder us or stop us, Father God. God. Oh God. Endow us today, Lord. Endow us, God, with your presence. Because we need you, Jesus. We need you, God. We don't need nothing. And nobody but you, God, if you don't give us nothing else. Oh God, we just want you, Jesus. If things don't go your way, if things don't go our way, we need you, God. We need you, God, because we know that you are the instructor. And you know what the best verse looks like. Oh, God. Oh, Baba, share that on mercy. We need you, God. We need you, God. We need you, God. We need you to direct our footsteps and guide our paths, God, because we don't know which way to go, Father God. It seems like so many times we stumble. It seems like so many times, God, we get confused. We don't know which way to turn, God. We don't even know if we can go backwards, God. But what we do know is that you order our footsteps, God. We can't make it without you, Jesus. We can't make it without you, God. Oh, God. We can't make it without you, God. I don't care how we try. I don't care what we've done. And I don't care how we do it, even how we imagine it could be done. Oh, God, we can't make it without you, God. Oh, God, how we need you. How we need you, God. How we need you, God. We need you to help us not to be distracted, God. We need you to help us, Father God, not to be so clouded with the cares of this life.
Thank you, Lord God.
And the people that is even in our lives. We need you, God. Oh, God. We need you, God.
Yes, God.
We need you to break some chains on today, God. We need you to lose some shackles, God, even from our past, God. Because we still holding on to some stuff, God, that's causing us to feel and do certain type of things, God. We need you to help us on today, God, to be loose from the burdens, God. We need you to help us on today, Father God. We need you like we never needed you before, God. And if by chance we never cried out, God, we cried out now.
My God.
Hold on.
Yes, God. Thank you, Jesus.
We need you, Jesus.
We thank you, Father.
Oh, God. We need you, God.
Jesus.
We need you to show us some things that's inside of our hearts, God.
Thank
because
you, Lord God.
It seems like we really can't see clear. It seems like we can't hear clearly.
Show us this, Lord God.
Oh, God, we need some help. We need you to show us what's really in our hearts, God. And even in the midst of showing us what's in our hearts, God, give us a heart to even accept what you're showing us, God, whether it's good or bad. Whether it's reproof or rebuke, God, because we know that you will buffet us and fashion us into what you want us to be.
Hallelujah.
Oh, God.
My God.
Help us out today, God. To worship you in spirit and in truth.
My God.
Help us to love you with everything in us, God, every muscle of our being, God. And if by chance we forgot to tell you that we love you, God, we want to tell you right now. We don't just need you and want you, God, we desire you, Father. Oh, God, and we want you to know, God, that you are everything to us, God. Oh God, let us know, Father God, that you are with us, God. Because sometimes we feel like we are all alone, God. Sometimes we feel like we don't have nowhere to escape, God. Sometimes we feel like we don't even know which way to go, what to do, and even how to do it. We be talking to the wrong person, God, when you write that stuff that I got. you are available for us, Father God. We can always come to you and talk, God, because you say you are a friend. Hold up. Hold up. We get so wrapped up into our own selves, Lord. We get so wrapped up into our own situations, God. We get so wrapped up into that thing, Father God, that seems like it's overtaking us, Father God. And we really don't know what we desire in our life, God, but we do know what we want, God. But we want you to expose the thing on today, Father God. We want you to open that thing up, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that we would know without a shadow of a doubt, God, that you are our keeper, God. You are our keeper. Oh, God, we ask you to help us, Father God, because we have sinned so much against you, God. We have done so many things, Father God, that's not even pleasing in your sight, Father God, and we don't even have enough dignity to confess. Oh, God.
My God.
Oh, God, we try to hide and sweep stuff under the rug, Father God, as if you are blinded.
My God.
We're not going to do that today, Father God.
Jesus.
We're going to open up all this stuff, Father God, because we know that you are our burden bearer, God.
God.
We know that you will help us even in the midst of our mess, Father God. And without a shadow of a doubt, God, we know that you are first and foremost. Oh, God, I'm asking you to help us out today, Father God.
Jesus.
Not that we would just confess, God, but we would turn, huh? Oh, God, we want to turn from ourselves, God. We want you to be you, that we won't be us, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God, we just want to be clean, God. We want to be washed by the Lord. But it seems like some of these things that we have inherited within our own selves, not from our lineage, Father God, and our ancestral traits, but inherited these things because we practice them. Oh, God, I'm asking you to help us, Father God, not to practice the way he does just shutting it up. I'm asking you to lose us from ourselves, Father God, because we are so entangled and so wrapped up in this mess.
My God. Jesus, help us.
Oh, God.
Help us, Lord. Jesus.
That we don't even see our hair.
Help us, God.
We don't even want to face our hair. Oh, God. We think we're walking right.
Yes,
we think we're talking right. We think we're living right, Father God,
and
we are doomed for perdition, God. God, help us, Father. Oh, God. Help us up today, Father God.
My
not
God.
To be so willingly to see the thoughts in others, huh?
Oh, God. Thank you, Lord God.
We always looking at somebody else, God.
Jesus.
On what they should and should not be doing, how they should and should not act, how they should and should not dress, how they should and should not talk, how they should present themselves, God. We always got something to say.
Jesus.
Oh, God. Help us on today, Father God. We are so mangled. We are so messed up, says God.
My God, my God, my God. Help us, Father.
Oh, God.
Help us,
increase
God. Him. Help us, Father.
Lord, I'm asking you to help us on today, God. Help us not to deceive our own selves, Father God, walking in our own righteousness, God. Remove the pride.
Jesus.
Remove that pride, Father God, in the name of Jesus. We always talk about what I love, Lord. When we wanted to do what he said.
Jesus.
Oh, God. Help us up today, Father God, in the name of Jesus. That we will not place nothing before you, God. oh God, and we think that it's a statue. No, it could be anything.
Jesus.
We place ourselves in a position to fall. And we want to blame everybody else for our own mess.
Jesus.
Help us, God. Help us that we won't be doomed and causing our own selves, God, to fall victim. Help us not to cause our own selves, God, to become entrapped in that we well, that we weave ourselves. Help us, God. Help us, God. Not to be concealed from the truth because of the blinders that we have placed upon our own eyes. Help some today, God. Help us on today, God, to be whipped, God, away from the mess. Oh, Mama, I say, local city. We're seeking the wrong stuff, says God. We want to be accepted. We want to be loved. We want to be rich. We want to have this. We want to have that. We are
better. Help us, God. Help us, Father.
Help God. What about our salvation?
My God. What about our salvation? What about you, God? Jesus.
Oh, God.
What about you, Father?
Help us on today, Father God. Oh, be content that we will be fashioned and formed the way that you planned it, God. We don't know what's best for ourselves, God. We don't know, God.
Jesus.
We ask you to help us, God. We ask you to move some things out of the way, Father God. There's so many things in our way, God. Until we not tripping over them, I'm going to go see we falling into them, says God. Sometimes you just got to back away from some stuff. Sometimes you just got to turn and walk away from some stuff. Don't let it be your doom, says God.
My God.
Jesus. What will you sacrifice for me?
For me.
What will you leave for me?
Jesus.
See, I left the throne. For you.
My God.
I left my comfort zone for you. Jesus.
God, we thank you, Father.
Oh,
we thank you, Jesus.
I love a pure place for you, says God.
Jesus.
I gave up everything for you.
You set free. You're the sound.
What will you sacrifice for me?
Hey, God.
Am I not precious enough for something, thank God?
My God.
Am I spared you for naught?
Jesus.
Am I not giving you even the very things that you desire? I gave you life. I gave you a better life, thanks God.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
I gave you what you could not even obtain of yours.
My God, my God.
And yet you give me nothing, not even a praise.
Not even a praise. Hallelujah, Jesus. Help us, God. Help us.
Oh, God.
My God, my God.
You won't give me nothing.
My my God.
And yet you keep asking for something.
There you go.
I cannot give you enough
to bring you joy.
Even before you ask him for more. I have even showed my hand to you, says God.
My God, my God, my God.
And moving some things that you can have a straight path. And yet, you don't even give me a thank you, Lord.
Jesus, we thank you, Father.
Oh, God, forgive us, Lord.
Forgive us, Father. Thank you, Lord God.
Forgive us, God, for putting these idols before you, God. Forgive us, Father God, for seeking after the wrong things, Father God. We really don't mean to do it, Father God. It seems like we just get to seeing this stuff, God, and we just fall victim, God. So we're going to confess today, Father God, that we did it. We're going to confess, God, that we is at fault, God. And then we're going to confess.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord, to your name, God.
Oh, God.
Father God, forgive us, for we know not, Lord God. Jesus.
Oh, God. Forgive us on today, God. Fashion us the way you want us to be. Take everything out of our hearts and our minds that's not like you, God. Remove it right now, God. Give us a heart of flesh, God, and as you speak to your people, God, it will stimulate some things. Oh, God, oh, God, oh, God. I'm asking you to circumcise our heart on today, God, because there's some things that's inside of us that is not needed. I'm asking you to help us even in our mind, God. Help us to renew our thoughts. Help us to renew them on today, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Because we don't want to keep going to the left or to the right, God. We want to go forward because we know it's the way to go. But we ask for you to help us on today, God. Because we cannot do it on our own. We always touching stuff. We always doing stuff. We always trying to make it happen and working it out our own way, Father God. Not even knowing, Father God, that you know what's best for us.
Renew our minds, God.
We think we know what's best.
Jesus,
we think we know how to act. We God. Think we know what to do. Oh, God, we really don't know what to do because we ain't got no solutions to know
how to do. Father God, lead us, Lord.
Oh, God is seems like every time we touch him, Father God, it gets worse and worse and worse, God.
Worse and worse, God.
Seems like every time we try to work it out, Father God, it seems like it don't even work out for us, Father God. Even when we try to do what your words say, Father God. When we do what your words say, Father God, it seems like it ain't even gonna go shot. Oh, God, but we ask you to impress some things in our hearts, God. We ask for you to impress some things in the bottom of our bellies, God. We ask for you to impress some things in our mind, God. That we won't be so wayward being tossed to and fro, Father God. We ask for you to remove that spirit of manipulation. We ask for you to remove that spirit of deception. We ask for you to cast all that stuff away from us, Father God. That we would not be so easily victimized.
Oh, God, let us not fall for God. Yes,
oh,
God. Yes, God. Yes, God.
We ask you to help us in our own way, Lord. Our home life, God. Because it seems like everything is in disarray. It seems like things ain't lining up the way you say they was going to line up, Father God. And even though they're not lining up the way you say that they was, Father God, we got to be patient even in our patience, God. Because we know, God, you're working that thing out. We may not be able to see it, Father God. But, Father, we believe it today. Oh, and we trust you, God.
Jesus.
We trust you, God. That you gotta move some things out the way, God.
Yes, God.
That you gotta fan some things out the way, Father God.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
We know without a shadow of a doubt that you are concerned about us, God.
Yes, God.
We know without a shadow of a doubt, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that you are concerned about us, God. And any problem that we have, any problem that may come up against us, Father God. We know that you said that our problems to you is as a drop in a bucket. It's just a small thing. So we're going to remove the limits out the way, Father God. Because we know that you are limitless, God. We know that there is nothing impossible with you. We know that you are great and greatly to be praised. You are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. We know that you are the author and the finisher of our faith, Father God. We know you already wrote our book, Father God, and even though we may not know the never-ending God. We know without a shadow of a doubt every chapter that we go through, Father God, there's an elevation and a lesson to be learned.
Yes, God.
We thank you, Father God, for revealing these things, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for uprooting some things, Father God. Because these are things that's been planted down inside of us, Father God, in the name of Jesus, seem like we can't uproot stuff. It's some things, Father God, that's been embedded inside of us, Father God, and it seems like we cannot get out of here. It seems like, Father God, we are trapped and confined in this thing. But we know, Father God, that you are the chain breaker.
You are the chain breaker, Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God.
We know that you can loose some things. We know that you can fix some things. How much do you want today, Father God, to encourage your people and let them know, Father God? Let them know just who you are, God, that you're supposed to be. Endow your people with your glory, God, that you're supposed to be. Let your glory and strength come through this place, Father God. And cap your angels in here, east, west, north, and south, from the root to the foundation, Father God, around the entire
world.
Everybody that crossed that threshold, Father God, give them what they need, God, that they will not leave this same room again. Oh God, give me what to say and how to say it as I stand before your people, God. I consider it and count it as an honor, God, and a privilege. Oh, Baba, I shouldn't even go. Oh God, remove that destitute state out of the lives of your people, God. Be cold, my mind, little girl. Let not your people be daring, Father God, and neither let them doubt. Oh God, help them up today, Father God, that they will not be deceived. Oh God, help your people on today, God. That they will not be deceived, God. Anoint your people on today, Father God. That they will be encouraged. Oh God. Give them the understanding they can offer, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Even as I speak your word, Father. Even as I give it to them on today, Father God, just how you gave it to me. Because we know without a shadow of a doubt, God, that there is nothing impossible with you. We know, God, that you are the King of Kings.
You are the King of Kings.
And the Lord of Lords. We know, God, that you are great. And you are great in the name of Jesus. We know, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that your righteousness, God, your mercy, and your grace are sufficient for your people. We know, Father God, in the name of Jesus. God, we ask you for some clarity on today, God. We ask you not just for some clarity, Father God. We ask you to open up some things to us, Father God. Because it seems like we're confused about some stuff, Father God. It seems like we don't know what way to go or what to do, Father God. It seems like, Father God, that we are entrapped in our own way, Father God. We done got out of position, Father God. We done got out of seat. Father God,
Jesus,
help us to
get back at your feet, Father.
Lord, we ask you to do some things for us, Father God. Because we need you like we never needed you before, Father God. We need you to restore some hope, God, in a hopeless situation. We need you to restore some things, Father God, that we thought could not even be restored. We ask you to give us some completion on today, Father God, because we feel like we're so incomplete. We ask you to do it on today, Father God, in the name of Jesus, because only you can. We ask you to open up some doors, Father God, that we thought was shut. We ask you to open up some doors, Father God, that we thought that we could not even open. We ask for you to open up some doors on today, Father God, in the name of Jesus, because you are the only way that we can get through that door. Father God, we lift you up on today, God. We lift you up on today, Father God.
We lift you up, Lord God,
above all God, Lord God. We lift you up on today, Father God. The beginning and the end. We recognize you for them today, Father God. Oh God, we recognize you. We recognize you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, as being our everything, God. We place so many things and stuff before you, Father God, but today we cast it down. Anything that even tried to exalt itself, we casting it down right now, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord God.
We thank you for your word on today, Father God. We thank you for enlightening us on today, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Because without your enlightenment, Father God, in the name of Jesus, we would be lost and let down. And we thank you, Father God, for being concerned that we will not be lost, Father God. Everything that you have given us, God, everything that we have even obtained, Father God, we know that it was from you. Oh, God, and we thank you right now, God, even for what you are about to do in our lives, God. We thank you in advance. We thank you in advance, God. We thank you for the completion, even in feeling incomplete. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, Baba, hallelujah. Oh, God. We thank you. Turn it down just a little bit, please. Come in, Joshua. I need your help. I need you to give everybody a red pen. Give everybody a red pen. I want you to write your name on that piece of paper and write the word love. Jesus. I want you to write your name on this piece of paper and write the word completion. I want you to write your name on that piece of paper. I want you to write the word remove. I want you to write this, your name on this piece of paper. And when you write your name on this piece of paper, the word that I'm going to give you, I want you to write it with everything in it. The word belief.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God.
And the word healing.
Thank you, God.
I want you to write your name on this piece of paper. And I want you to write, I accept, Lord. See, that's the stuff for you. I want you to write your name on this piece of paper. And I want you to write, I love you, Lord. I want you to write your name on this piece of paper. And I want you to write completion. Not complete, completion. Did I give you a paper yet? I want you to write your name on this piece of paper. And I want you to write, yes, Lord. Just write yes, Lord. Because he already told you. Just say yes, Lord. Just say yes, Lord. I want you to write this, your name on this piece of paper. And I want you to write, I give. I give. You know, like I surrender, but you got to write, I give. I want you to write your name on this piece of paper. And write, if I told you once, did I give everybody a piece of paper? I want you to write your name on this piece of paper. And I want you to write, okay, Lord. Okay.
Alright.
Just everybody got a red pen? Joshua. Okay, I want you to write your name on this piece of paper. I want you to write your name on this piece of paper, sweetie. How you doing? And I want you to write, I believe. I want you to write your name on that piece of paper and write, I trust you, God. Did I get everybody? I'm going to sit this here. So, this morning, when y'all get through, just, Joshua, collect the yellow sheets of paper for me, baby, and bring them up here. Please. Minister Simeon, would you take this stuff to the wall for me, please? This morning, when the Lord was talking to me this morning, he started revealing some things to me concerning his people. All of us, including me. And in the midst of him revealing these things to me, he started letting me know what we are doing and how we are erring and not even knowing that we are erring. Because a lot of us, in our own hearts and in our own minds, we believe that we're doing something right and that we are a good person because we're doing this and we're not doing this. But the Lord told me on today that we are erring because not only is we not doing what he tells us to do, we have not yet completely and solely said yes, Lord. It has nothing to do with you not loving God. You can love God, and you can still not surrender all to him. You can still not completely give him that situation that's bothering you. You can still not completely and solely open up your heart and your mind unto him. You can still not be obedient. How about not sacrificing nothing for him? How about that? We don't sacrifice for God. We don't sacrifice for God. A lot of us don't want to put stuff, put it into ministry. Simeon, please. A lot of us don't want to let go of some things, turn some things, stop some things. A lot of us put so many things before God. And he gave me some scriptures on today. I want you to turn it down a little lower because I want it to keep playing. And when I tell you to stop it from playing, just stop it from playing for me, prophetess, please. A lot of us don't want to just do what God tells us to do. A lot of us want to keep doing what we want to do and how we want to do it, and then we want to rebel. We want to rebel not just with our everyday people, our husbands, our wives, our sisters, our brothers, our mothers, our fathers, our men, but we rebelling against the very person who formed us. The Bible says that rebellion is a form of witchcraft. We practice all these things, and yet we do not even know that we're practicing these things. The Bible says it's better to be obedient to him. Obedience is better than a sacrifice. So in being obedient to him, what actually are you sacrificing? What actually are you doing? We put so many things above God. We put people before God. We put stuff before God. We place these things, you know, and I need my glasses. I can't see when I read. I don't know what I did. But thank you so much for getting my glasses. We have a tendency of forgetting, you know, exactly from whence cometh our help coming from the Lord. We come into this place and we say, yes, Lord, but are we really saying, yes, Lord, your will be done? Do we really want his will to be done? Because when he starts doing his will, we always have a tendency of turning and thinking that it ain't him and trying to blame everything on the devil. The devil is a liar. What is the devil lying about? We already know he a liar and ain't the truth ain't in him.
That's true.
We already know that. You ain't got to keep reminding him. He know he a liar. He already know he ain't Jack Billy Squat. He know he's God's flunky and he can't do anything to any of us without God's permission. But we blaming him for everything that's going wrong in our lives when in actuality we put our own self in that position because of our disobedience. I'm talking about all of us. The Bible says so. I'm gonna read some scriptures, and I'm gonna go through these scriptures quickly. Then I want to get to the story. I want to get to the story of the matter of the whole thing, because today is the day that we're gonna have to make a decision. We gotta make a decision today because time is winding down and it's running out. I cannot reiterate it enough. I cannot say it enough. And because we believe that people and leaders and folk and Christian, whoever you want to say it is, it can be a sinner, man. If they say time is winding down, we don't want to believe it, and time go on, and then it been 10 years later, and say, listen to me when I sit up here and tell you, I cannot reiterate it. Time is winding down. So if you never, ever, ever knew God, you better try to learn now. If you never, ever, ever believed him and trusted him, now's the time to do it. Listen to me today. Our first scripture is going to be my main man, Joshua. I love Joshua so much. Because he was not just a man of obedience. He was teachable. He was a teachable man. And he learned everything that he could from the man that God placed over him. Let's go to the book of Joshua. We're going to go to the 24th chapter. And we're going to read just two verses. In the book of Joshua. Y'all can get a Bible if you want to. I see you looking, Joshua. Go ahead. It's one on the seats over here. I see you looking. You've been studying Joshua like I told you today, so you should know this. the book of Joshua. His real name is Keel. I'll be calling him Joshua because God says that he's Joshua. So, we're going to go to the 24th chapter, and we're going to read just two verses, 14 and 15. Read that for me, please.
Now, therefore, fear the Lord.
I want you to read it just a little bit louder. We ain't even scared of God no more. The Bible says that he's the same today, yesterday, and forevermore, and we ain't even afraid of him. Joshua is giving us some instructions. What could say? Read it.
Now, therefore, fear the Lord.
Fear the Lord.
And serve him in sincerity.
And serve him in sincerity. What does sincerity mean? With everything in you and with truth. And what? Come on. Sincerity and what?
And in truth.
And in truth. You cannot serve God in sincerity and lie. Oh, I'm serving him with everything in me, but really you ain't. It's a lie. He says, serve me in sincerity and in truth. Read.
And put away the gods which your father served. The gods.
Keep going. Don't
which
stop.
Your father served on the other side
Hold
of the
on
flood.
A minute. Hold on a minute, because I want you to talk in your evangelist voice. That's what. Start from the top.
Now, therefore, fear the Lord.
He said, "Fear me
and serve him in sincerity.
And serve me with everything in you
and in truth. And put away the gods which you." Your father
that stuff
served.
You've been doing, I want you to stop doing it. That stuff that you learned from your mommy and your daddy that you thought it was okay, I want you to stop doing it. I want you to stop doing what you see other folk do. I want you to stop doing what you read. I want you to stop doing what you even think is right. He said, put it away from you. Come on, read.
On the other side of the flood.
I brought you from that place of bondage. I brought you from that place where you thought that you were stuck at. I opened up your heart and your mind that you may be able to understand me. And yet, you keep on practicing them always. And when stuff ain't going your way, you say, oh, everything going wrong now since I started serving God. He said, stop it.
Wow.
Come on.
And in Egypt, and serve ye the Lord.
I say serve me. Not that job you got because you know you got a paycheck coming this week. No. I didn't say serve me. I didn't say serve that supervisor that you think will raise you up.
Jesus.
I didn't say serve your pastor where you think you would get elevated. I said serve who? Me, says God.
Yes, God.
You serving the wrong stuff. You putting the wrong things in the front of me. You exalting all this stuff and all these people and all these things. You doing it, not me. I'm telling you what your area is. And you don't even know you doing it because you say you love me. Oh, I love the Lord with all my heart. Yeah, but you love me so until you put something or somebody before me. How about I love God and I don't feel like going to church today because I'm just tired.
Jesus.
I've been doing this. You know what? And he know my heart. Jesus. He know my heart. He know I love him. He know I'm sitting there. Is you sacrificing your tiredness? Is you sacrifice? Oh, I gotta go to work today. You know what? I need to give me some sleep because I gotta be at work at 3:00. Church at 10 a.m. What? You gotta go. I just need some sleep. Sure, I've been working all week. I done did this and I done did that and I just need to get me. I'm just gonna miss this. Come on.
And if it seem evil unto you to serve the
Wait
Lord.
A minute. Am I asking you to do too much? Am I asking you to do too much when I say to praise me and to serve me? See, because a lot of people believe like, oh, okay. God just asking too much. He's too hard. Don't you know this woman of God that's sitting in the pulpit told me one day, she said, God, the Bible is hard.
Jesus.
The Bible hard, and the things that Paul said, I can't get with that. We're talking about somebody that's sitting in a pulpit.
Amen, Paul.
What are you going to sacrifice for me, says God? Y'all remember what he had me praying? Do y'all remember the word he had spoke to me while I was in prayer this morning?
Jesus.
That wasn't me. Y'all do know that was God talking through me.
Jesus.
What are you going to sacrifice for me? Come on.
Choose you this day.
Choose today. Didn't I tell y'all, y'all got to make a decision?
Yes.
You got to choose today, not tomorrow, not next week. You got to choose. Choose what?
Whom ye will serve.
Whom you going to serve? Is you going to serve that stuff? Come on, go to Matthew chapter 6. What is you going to serve? See, we've been serving so much stuff. We've been putting so much stuff in front of God. We've been holding on to all this stuff. And lo and behold, you all know that we all want some money. Oh, we always want some money. We want some money because we know that money solves all things. We know that because the Bible says so. We want some money because we want to have everything that we want. If God gave you the money that you say you want, you will never go on your knees for nothing. You will put your trust in that money. Oh, wait a minute. You already done put your trust in that money. Because you know without a shadow of a doubt, you got a paycheck coming next week. Oh, wait a minute. Hold it. This week. You know without a shadow of a doubt, because you push that clock each and every doggone day, that you got a check coming. Because I got a certain amount of hours. And guess what? I even got some overtime. I know I can do something extra. Come on, read. Read.
Lay not up for yourself treasures.
We want to put all this stuff up. We want to put all this stuff up. We want to get all the money that we can in store. Let me tell y'all something. I know this guy years ago that I used to think. This man used to work so much. He was an engineer. He used to work so much, and I used to always tell him, I'd be like, look, what? Why in the world? What? You going to just make all the money in the world? He already was making $32 an hour. I mean, you won't work overtime. You work Monday through Friday. You ain't even got to go to work on Saturdays and Sundays. And so in between all this, you still working for your own self on the outside, doing IT work. Because he's an engineer, computer, IT. You doing IT work on the side. Making anywhere from $200 to $300 an hour. Because when you go to these people's houses, they want you to do something. And in the midst of you doing it, you charging them this baby and they willing to pay. They willing to pay because they want this thing to be doing right. And just stacking it up. Just stacking it up. Listen to me when I sit up here and tell you. I just had to ask one day. I said, what you trying to just make all the money in the world? He said, you can't never get enough money. I said, I already know we can't make. Because you got your heart in the wrong place. You got your heart in the wrong stuff. What do the Bible say about that?
Where mouth and rust does corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal.
If you take some money and you trying to save all this money, you know how we get a piggy bank or a jar or something, and we put a whole bunch of change in. And then we take that change and we start throwing dollars inside of that change. If you leave that money inside, that paper money inside of that change long enough, don't y'all know that that change and the nickel that's inside of that change is going to start eating up them dollar bills? Leave it in there long enough to watch it see when you're picking up, it's going to crumble. See, we got our hearts and our minds in the wrong place. Come on, read.
But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt.
We don't even want to do that. Because the Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all else will be added unto you. We don't even want to seek what God got. We don't want to seek his righteousness because we're all walking around in self-righteousness. Think we got it all together. Oh, and I'll tell you because I know the word. And oh, I do this and I do that. And oh, I'm faithful to God. And so, you ain't faithful. You won't even sacrifice for him. What are you sacrificing for God? What did he have me to y'all this morning? I sacrificed so much for y'all. I even came down up off the throne for you.
Jesus.
He said, I came down. He was, y'all know he lived plush up there, don't y'all?
My God.
Because the ground is gold.
Mm.
Y'all know when you're getting ready to enter into, you're going through some pearly gates, pearls. Where pearls are? So, we won't sacrifice nothing for God. Come on, read.
And where thieves do not break through nor steal.
You can't even get no sleep because you got all this stuff and you scared somebody gonna take it from you. So now you wanna get
lights, you want to be camera action, you want to see everything, who coming in and going out, you even paying somebody to watch over that mess. We something. When we get it, we something. You are even scared to, nope, I ain't gonna say that. Come on, read.
For where your treasure is, there will your
so
heart will.
So wherever you put all your faith and all your trust in and all your belief in and all what you see, that's where your heart at. But you say you love my God. You say you love God. You say you love him with everything in you. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
The light of the body is the eye.
I want you to go all the way down to verse 24.
No man can serve two masters.
You can't
but
serve.
Either he will hate the one and love the other.
Everything that we do, we really don't want to do. And when we wind up doing it over and over again, we get to hate and do it. I really don't want to be like this, but I'm like this. I really don't want to be greedy, but I'm greedy. I really don't want to be selfish, but I'm selfish. I really don't want to be emotionless, but I'm emotionless. I really don't want to be inconsiderate, but I can't be considerate because I don't even know how. I really don't want to be like that, so I'm asking God to help. What are you sacrificing? For real, for real. What are you sacrificing? For real, for real. Are you mindful, even or anybody else? Are we?
My God.
Are we? Nope. Because we ain't even mindful of what we supposed to do for him. So how can you be? Come on.
Or else, he will hold to the one.
Stop, baby. We're moving on. Go to 1 Timothy chapter 6. And we're going to start at verse 6. Because it don't matter what God do for us, it don't matter what he give us, it don't matter how much he give us, it don't matter who he give us, it don't matter what he give us, it does not matter. We still ain't satisfied.
Jesus.
We want more. We want more everything. We want more everything. We want more of every kind of picking thing that eyes ain't satisfied with seeing and ears ain't even satisfied with. We want more. And we cannot even obtain everything that we get. And then when we do got it, what you gonna do with it? You won't even share it. Oh, wow. He said you won't even share it. You don't want it because it's mine. It's all about you and yours. You know how we say, because I used to say it all the time. It's all about me and mine. I won't give a rat's tail about nobody else if it ain't got nothing to do with me and mine. Too. Good day to them. I'm so glad God delivered me from that attitude and that kind of heart.
Jesus.
I am. Because I don't believe that he'll have me standing here today.
Mm-mm.
I'm so glad he delivered me from that stuff.
My God.
The Bible says to love everybody as you love yourself.
Amen.
You will not. Ain't nobody in here doing that.
Jesus.
Nobody.
Mm.
For real, for real. Because I love me some me. Not only do I love me some me, I love me some y'all. For real, for real. I don't play. I can't do that. Because when I thought I was loving, that's when I was playing until he showed me how to love for real. Come on, read.
But godliness with contentment is great.
We ain't content. We ain't satisfied. We always want more. The Bible says, oh, wait a minute. Hold on. Oh, but I love God. I know God. You ain't even satisfied. You complain about each and every little bitty thing. I wouldn't give a rat's tail what it is. I wouldn't care who it is. You complain about somebody saying something to somebody else and you don't even know what they were saying. You got, come on. Mm-hmm. We complain about this person ain't doing that and that person ain't doing this. What are you expecting? How do you know that that person don't even know how to do what you expecting? Because they never received it themselves. They were never taught it. We expect too much. And yet, we want to sacrifice nothing. We
We don't want to do it. We don't want to do it because of the godlessness that we have within ourselves. The Bible says, what? Godliness what?
With contentment is great gain.
It's great. You can gain everything in the world if you just content in your current situation. Your current circumstance. Because let me tell you something. God used people to bless other people. And if you content exactly what you're doing, how you're doing it, whatever, whatever, and stop being so greedy and stop trying to obtain this and stop trying to do this and stop trying to be recognized and stop trying to be acknowledged and stop trying, well, I'm this and that. I so what? Because ain't none of us nothing up against God. Nobody. Don't nobody know nothing no more than him. So stop thinking that you know everything. I don't care how many degrees you got. I don't care what you think that you done obtained in this life. Stop thinking that you even got more than anybody else because your job pays just a little bit more than theirs. Oh, I got benefits. Oh, my benefits is there. And oh, you ain't got no benefits because you ain't even got God. You ain't even content with what you got because you want just a little bit more. We didn't even have a good job, but we still looking for a better job. What's that all about? We not content because we ain't satisfied. We can't be satisfied with nothing. The Lord destroyed thousands of people in the wilderness all because of their
complaints.
Stop complaining so much. You get a little toe ache, you hit your toe, you be about to cuss. And then walking around like this for the rest of the next 2 days. What's wrong with you? I hit my toe the other day. It's, we can't take no pain. We can't take no physical pain, let alone emotional pain. Let somebody say something to you wrong. Or let somebody say something to, that you feel like that they didn't say it right. Or how about they ain't said enough? We be expecting people to say something so much and so often and so when you want it until you get something different, then you get the feeling some type of way. So much you ain't even satisfied with what I done said already. Boy, girl, bad. Get it together. We want everybody to sacrifice some things for us, but we don't want to sacrifice nothing for nobody else when the Bible says love others as you love your own self. Can you love somebody like you love you? Mm-hmm. You, what's your name, baby?
Joanna.
My name is Edify. Can you love somebody like you love somebody, like you love yourself? No, for real, for real.
You gotta love them better.
You gotta love them who?
Better.
Say it again.
Better.
Can you love somebody better than you love yourself? Oh, that's hard. Don't answer it. Don't nobody answer it. Don't nobody answer it. For real, for real. Because we put any and everything before God. Come on, read the book.
For we bow nothing into this world.
We can't take nothing with. Come on.
And it is certain we can carry nothing.
I don't care what you attain or what you got. It ain't nothing that you can take with you. I don't care how many jewels you got, how many houses, how many cars, how many better jobs. You can't take nothing with you. When you lay yourself down, the only thing that you're going to. Oh, wait. You can't even take that body with you that you borrowed. It ain't even going. You can't take nothing with you. You can't. So what you about to kill yourself for in obtaining it? You can't take nothing with you. Come on, read.
And having food and raiment, let us be therewith content.
You ain't content with what you got. So God say that if I can trust you a little, I'll make you rule over one. So let me tell you something. You say, oh, okay, God, if you can trust me, how is he going to trust you? If I just hold on to it, I'm just going to put it in my pocket and I'm just going to keep it. Because he can trust me with that. Because I ain't going to do nothing with it. No, what he gave you, and because you're trying to hide it, because you're trying to keep it, he's going to take what he gave you. So why would he do that? If he trusted me with this stuff. Because you selfish and you greedy. Mm-hmm. You don't want to do nothing with it. And you ain't scared of me. Come on.
But they that will be rich fall into temptation and a snare and into misery.
And the more money you get, the more you want to do, the more funny you act, the more you try to obtain, the more you fall into temptation of what? Read.
And hurtful lusts with grown men and destruction. And perdition.
And send you straight to hell. That's what perdition means, y'all. Hell. Read.
For the love of money is the root of
all evil. See, a lot of people quote the scripture wrong. They be like, money is the root to all evil. No, it's not. The Bible says money solves all things.
That's right.
But the love of money will cause you to act some type of way. I don't even care if you in the church.
Yeah.
You can fall into filthy lucre. You can fall into greed. You can fall you all kind of foolishness, deceit, manipulate, all kind of mess.
For money.
He said the love of money. So who love money more than they love God? Please don't answer that. Don't raise no hands. Who love money more than they love God? 90% of us. Because I love my job. I know my job is going to give me this. And I know my job is going to give me that. What are you sacrificing for God? Are you letting go of that money to say yes, Lord? Are you going to... If he tell you to quit your job right now and trust me, I'm going to take care of you. Who going to do it? Please don't answer that. I know nobody. Because I got bills to pay. And because I can't see that paycheck that I'm supposed to get and you told me to quit that job. I know I can't see that paycheck because it ain't coming because guess what? I ain't punching that clock. I ain't punching that clock. I know it ain't coming my way. I ain't worked since February the 25th, the year 2000. I've been working for God ever since. He takes care of me. He takes care of me. And it ain't the tithes and offering that pay all the bills. Are y'all listening to me? I just got a little bit more I want to tell y'all. Come on. Read.
Which love are some coveted after, they have erred from the faith
you
and
erred.
Pierced themselves through with many sorrows.
You want me to tell you how you pierce yourself and you err? Because you're so worried about where I'm going to get this and how I'm going to get that and when I'm going to get this and can I get raised and can I do this or let me figure this out, let me figure that out. God gave us all gifts and talents. And if we use our gifts and talents, we wouldn't even have a punch a clock for nobody but ourselves. Did you hear what I say? I've been working for myself way before I got out the secular world. A long time, God done gave me everything that I ever, ever wanted. For real, for real. For real, for real. And I done turned and walked away from it all. Several times. Knowing and trusting and content, believing God gonna take care of me. God gonna take care of me. I believe that with everything in me. With every morsel of my, I don't care what it look like, because I done been there. I done envisioned it visibly with my own eyes, seeing it, living it. Didn't see a way out, baby. I did not even know a way out. I could not even imagine a way out. And so I put my hands up. I said, you know what, God, I'm done. I can't even figure it out. I can't even figure it out. We can't figure each other out. I don't care how long you've been doing them. You can't figure out anything by your own selves. Nobody in here. So stop thinking something. Stop thinking something. Don't no two people think the same. We always looking for fault in other folks. Or they do this, or they don't do this, or they act like this, or they act like that. Let me tell y'all something about fault. Because the Bible says love covers a multitude of sins. So that fault that you say you see in me, you love me, I think you say you love me, it goes to cover some stuff. Because our faults was covered by who?
Jesus. That's right.
And we always say, Lord, make me more like him. I want to be like you, Lord. Give me the heart of you, Lord. We always saying that kind of stuff. But we don't want to do it. And we're not even content. When God gives us something, we don't even want what he gives us. And that could be, and I ain't talking about no relationships. I ain't talking about no houses and cars. I'm talking, how about if he give you common sense? He gave us 5 6 of common.
We don't even want to use common sense. We don't even want to use the logic of it all. And then we complain. We complain about the situation, about the circumstance. I heard half chance. That's what I heard. Come on.
But thou, O man of God, flee these things and follow after
righteousness. Let's go to 1 John. Because he's going down the line. He's talking about the houses, the cars, the money, the all the stuff. The people, the human beings, and all the stuff. And I'm going to get to my story. I just want to give y'all a little history and a little insight on what he say that we should and what we should not do. Because we are never happy with nothing. And we always seek it. And then half of the stuff that we do desire, whether it be our present, our past, or even our future, we don't even want to let go of stuff. Come on. Read.
Love not the world.
So what is loving the world? All the stuff that's inside of it. Read the book. Don't stop.
Neither the things that are in the world.
All the stuff that goes in.
If you love the world, the love of the Father is not in you.
You do not love God. Oh, wait a minute. He say his love is not inside of you. Come on, read.
For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, and the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, is not the Father, but is of the world.
What they doing, or what they saying, our flesh never gets saved. So we're going to fall victim to the lusts of our flesh. And it's not just going to be one or two little bitty things. It's going to be all the things that we desire. We're talking about our addictions. And I don't care what it is, from coffee, to cigarettes, to sex, to anything. I wouldn't give a rat's tail what it is. It's everything. But we fall victim to it because it's part of the world. And we are victims of it. Why? Because we live in it. And because we see it. Because we practice it. Because we embrace it. Because we want it. And we just want to step back away from it. It's so much stuff that we need to just step back away from. We don't want to sacrifice nothing for God. We don't want to sacrifice nothing for God. It's only one man. Come on.
And the world passeth away, and the lust thereof.
Let's go to Genesis. I can't even hold it in no more. I got to take y'all to the story. Y'all got to hear about this man called Abraham.
Come on, man.
We talking about somebody that did not just sacrifice, but he was giving it all up just for God. We talking about a man who sacrificed everything, and even his plus life, just for God and being obedient. We talking about a man, and God said, listen to me. I got to get calm because I'm getting ahead of myself. We talking about this man called Abraham. The very first time he heard God's voice, God said, come on, get up. Go here. He did not question God at nail time. He sacrificed everything and left it all. He just turned around and walked away from it all. Because God gave him a promise. He told him he was going to do something for him and through him. Now mind you, he did not tell that man where he was going to take him to. He didn't tell him the journey he had to take, or even the road he had to go in order for him to get there. So it's a lot of times that God didn't already told you the end of your journey, baby. But you don't even know what you got to go through and getting to that end. Because the journey ain't easy. The Bible says there's a lot of long suffering that come along with it. So stop thinking that the devil doing anything. It's some stuff that God is allowing you to go through in your life because he got to teach you some things. See, we got to learn how to appreciate some stuff before God can even give us some more. And then when he do give us some more, we have to take baby steps. Because sometimes when you leap into something, you're going to always have to fall back. And 90% of the time, and listen to me, if y'all will never listen to me again in y'all life, you always got to go down before he bring you up, baby. Are y'all listening to me?
Jesus.
If you ain't already down on your knees, he going to make you get on there. You got to learn how to appreciate God. You got to learn how to appreciate him even in your current situation. You got to learn how to appreciate him even when you think things ain't even going right. Because this road that you're going on, this journey that you're taking, you do not even know where you're going. But would you even trust God that he's going to lead you to your divine destiny? Because he's the only one that can do it.
I don't care what you saw, what you think, what you went through, or how you went through it, or how often you go through it, and whenever you went through it, just know it was, and it's not is.
Wow.
Y'all know, did y'all get that?
Yeah.
Do I gotta say it again?
Say it again.
We're not gonna talk about what was.
Come on now.
Let's get into what is. Because the Bible say, now faith. It don't say nothing about what happened yesterday. It don't say nothing about what happened or what you think is going to get ready to happen. It say, now, right now.
In the present, right?
Right now. We talking about the current stuff. See, you got to be able to go through the current stuff before you be able to get to the stuff.
Come on now.
Are y'all following me this morning?
Yes, yes.
Y'all really following me?
Yes.
See, because Abraham didn't really know where he was going.
Mm-mm.
But he trusted and he believed God that he was going to take him through this journey. And in the midst of it, he went through all kind of havoc and all kind of what's that. And not only that, God gave him a woman that was barren and could not even have no kids.
Jesus.
So what was the hope in that? In the midst of him being obedient to God, God said, you know what? I got to listen to me. Let me tell you something. When you chosen by God and he done made you some promises, baby, let me tell you, the devil and hell ain't stopping. Are y'all listening to me? Because us women and us men have a tendency of trying to put our hands to some things and trying to fix some things on our own and make some things happen. See, when you get so concerned about everything and everybody else that's all, and you get all so wrapped up, you will be the missed out on your stuff because you're trying to make sure everybody else got their stuff. Everybody don't walk into the inheritance with you because they could very well not even be their seed.
That's right.
Are you listening to me?
Yep.
And if it is not that person's season, do not grieve the Holy Spirit by trying to put your hands on it. Exhale.
Right. Let it go.
Exhale. God had already promised them that they was going to have kids.
Mm.
But because she was so impatient and could not wait for her promise, she put her hand to it and gave her husband to another woman. Who does that? I ain't gonna answer that. For real. Folk is a mess. We are a mess. We always put our hands up trying to make stuff happen.
Mm-hmm.
Get your hands off and get out of God's business. We always in his business, but we want to sacrifice our happiness for somebody else. But then, what are you sacrificing for God? He done already gave you a promise. He done already told you what he was going to do. He done already showed you the end. You just didn't know what you had to go through. You didn't know what you had to go through. And in the midst of it, it was all kind of confusion and havoc in the midst of that mess that Sarah put her hands to. My God, help us all. Help us to be more obedient to your word and to your will, God. We don't want God's will to be doing because we always try to do our will and in the midst of his will thinking we're doing something right. And we ain't doing nothing right. You do what you want to do. How you want to do it. That's what we doing. That's what we doing. All of us, me, you, him, her, they, we ain't us. All of us, ain't none of us exempt. We a big, hot, dilly ocean of a mess. And then we sit up here and we try to wonder and try to figure out why everything is happening to us the way that it's happening and why it's not happening the way it should happen. You done already messed up stuff when you did this and you did this. Now you want everything to line up. How about you get in position?
Jesus.
How about you get in position?
My God.
And so God can do what he can do. And so in the midst of it, everybody know the story about Sarah. And then Hagar had a baby. And then in the midst of Hagar having a baby, because she gave away her blessing to another woman. Now she mad at the woman. What you mad for? You did that. You caused that mess. And in the middle of the mess, Hagar had to humble herself to the very person who didn't even like her.
That's right.
Sometimes you just gotta humble yourself.
Gotta humble yourself.
Under the mighty hand of God. It ain't the person that you humbling yourself to. You humbling yourself under the mighty hand of God out of obedience. What are you going to sacrifice? Don't y'all know that that was a sacrifice for Hagar?
Yep.
For real.
Sure was.
It ain't easy loving, embracing, and talking and being around folk that you know hate you. But what is you going to sacrifice for the sake of godliness? That you may enter into your promise. That you may enter into your inheritance. What? We don't want to sacrifice nothing. You think you're going through stuff, just go through stuff over and over again, year after year after year, no? What? You sacrificing your what, peace? What are you sacrificing? And you don't think you're going to get rewarded? What? Even in the midst of Hagar sacrificing to be around somebody she hates, guess what? God rewarded her.
Jesus.
Made her son a king too.
That's right.
It gets deeper than that. It gets deeper than that. Because in the midst of his wife being barren, God opened up her womb and let her have her own baby.
That's right.
Even though she had messed up and touched this stuff and tried to make something happen. She was so, this lady went on out, and when Hagar got pregnant, she said, here, sit on my lap so when you birth the baby, it'll come up like she had it. We really try to make things come to life with our vain imaginations. What are we sacrificing? So, Sarah had a baby and never had a baby in her life. Was barren. She had a baby. In the midst of having this baby, the Bible says that the baby grew and all this and all that. And the Bible said that Abraham loved his son Isaac so much. He just loved him so much. And such. And then the Bible says that the Lord said, in the wee nights of hour, he woke a man up and told him, come on, get up. Get up. I done gave you everything you ever wanted. Now what you fit to sacrifice for me? Kill your son. Kill your son. Kill your only son. By the only woman that you ever loved. Because he never loved Hagar. He only took her because her wife said so. The wife got some kind of clout in the lives of a man. The Bible talks about it. Listen to me. Listen to me. Not only was he obedient, the Bible says in Genesis, I want to say it's chapter 22. I want to say, yep, Genesis chapter 22. Come on. I want y'all to hear the story because I don't want y'all to think I'm making this stuff up. Start from the top. Genesis. Chapter 22.
And it came to pass after these things that God did tempt Abraham and said unto him, Abraham.
See, sometimes God tries us and see exactly where our heart's at. We can say that our hearts is with God. We love God. God did God that God. We God speaking in tongues, doing this and doing that. We can literally say all these things. But in actuality, where's your heart at? Where is your heart at towards God? Is it in that job? Is it in that man? Is it in that house? Is it in that woman? Is it in that car? Is it in that money? Is it in that property? Is it, what is it in? Where is your heart at for real? Come on, read the book.
And he said, behold, here I am. And he said,
we, as men and women of God, the every time God calls on our name, we answer.
Jesus.
Come on, read.
Take now thy son, thy only son, Isaac.
Not
thou
just
lovest,
your son, but the only the son, the one that you know with everything in you. If the Lord tell you to kill your kid right now, what you doing? Please don't ask that.
And offer him therefore a burnt offering upon
not
one of the mountains.
Kill him,
which
he said,
I
said, burn him. So y'all know that's kind of like torture, ain't it?
Jesus.
That's not. If the Lord tell you to kill Christian, you, you can't do it. See that? See what I'm saying? It's hard. If God tell you to kill your baby, could you kill your baby? Who in here can kill their baby? If God tell you to kill your daughter, could you kill your daughter? Could? Ooh, I love my kids. My daughter 31 and my son 28. They're my babies. I call my daughter Ladybug, and my son is grown, and I call him Mama's big boy and Mama's little man. Look, your only boy, the only child you ever conceived, could you kill Daniel? For real. Oh, she felt that thing. You felt it, didn't you? You having kids. Thank God. Could you kill your... She like, don't ask me that. He had to ask you that before, didn't he? Like, no, don't ask me, don't. You can't kill them seeds, man. That's something hard to do. Could you kill your daughter? Ooh, look. Tell you right now, why you ask me that, man? Leave me alone. Don't go asking me that. You couldn't kill... You gonna kill that man, baby? You can't do it. We already know about you. We can't do that. We can't. We can't kill our kids. We wouldn't even want to kill our kids. And even the thought of it, it's a stinging, ain't it? It's a piercing. Could you kill Jack? If the Lord tell you to kill, no, don't you answer this. No. Listen to me. The Bible says that read it.
And Abraham arose up early
the
in the morning.
The Bible says he first asked them, I'm telling you what to do. I'm waking you up in the middle of the night, and I'm telling you, get up and go sacrifice your son unto me as a burnt offering. Now, when they gave sacrifices then, the first thing that they do was grab them by their head and slit the necks or whatever they were sacrificing that animal. And then they were burned. So guess what? He had to overkill. He had to first cut his baby neck. Then he had to burn him. Read the book.
And saddled his ass and took two of
the
his
The Bible says that he got up early in the morning. He said, oh, Lord, you know what? Even the son that you gave me that I didn't even think that I was going to have by the woman that I love, Lord, I am going to give him right back to you because it's you that gave him to me. The Bible says he got up and saddled his ass, which is a donkey. Somebody said that yesterday. Like a donkey. He saddled his donkey. And he took that donkey and his son and some of his servants. The Bible says that he left. Come on, read.
And Isaac, his son, and clave the wood for the burnt offering and
now,
rose up.
Too. He even made his son carry the wood that's fit to burn him up. And he didn't even know it. Come on, read.
And went unto the place of which God had told him.
Now,
then
man,
on the third day,
he done got up. Because the Lord done already told him in the beginning. He said, I will show you where to go to do that. See, God is a God of specifics. We may think that God don't know the plan. He already know the story. He know the chapter. Y'all should have been here for prayer. All this stuff he's saying in prayer. Listen to me when I sit up here and tell you. He already know. What will we sacrifice for God? What will you actually sacrifice for him? Would you sacrifice that promise that he gave you? Would you sacrifice it and turn and walk away? Would you sacrifice that promise he gave you? Would you? I don't care what the promise may be. Would you do it? Isaac was a promise. He was a promise, y'all. A dire promise. Who in here ain't got no kids? I bet they want some. I bet they desire to have some. Don't you want some kids? And mad because you ain't had none already. The ones who ain't got any desire. And then when half chance happens, and then you can't have none, and you wondering why, oh God, why that had to happen to me so I can't have a kid? So now you got to love on everybody else. Let me tell you, I was there because they said I would never have kids. I got two today and seven grandbabies. So I know the promise. Oh, that promise, baby. That promise. That promise is what gives us hope. Am I right? That promise is what keeps us flourishing and keep us going. That promise. Come on, read.
Then on the third day, Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the place afar off.
You know what? People don't even know. Y'all know God, Jesus rose on the third day. The significance, I wanna really show y'all how that ties into the ultimate sacrifice.
The ultimate sacrifice.
Oh God. Compared to the sacrifices that we don't want to make. We don't want to make no sacrifices for God. The Bible says what? Read.
And Abraham said unto his young men, abide ye here with the ass, and
so
I
you don't want
and the lad will go yonder and worship and come again to you.
Go.
And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it upon Isaac his son. And he took the fire in his hand and a knife, and they went both of them together.
Look,
and Isaac spake.
He gonna kill him, he gonna slam him, then he finna burn him. Because God told him to.
Jesus.
If God tell you to sacrifice everything right now, your job, your house, your car, whatever it is, and turn and walk away, will you sacrifice it all for him? This man sacrificed his only son,
Jesus,
whom he loved. God. That's what the Bible says.
Jesus, the
what are you going to sacrifice for God? We don't want to stop doing nothing. We don't want to stop doing anything. We'll do sacrifice. What are you going to sacrifice for God?
Jesus.
For real, think about it. Oh, sure.
My God,
I do drugs,
my God, my God.
I know. I used to do drugs, and I thought I could never touch it again
Jesus.
In my life. For real,
my
for
God.
Real. Is you going to sacrifice it? Can you really say, well, how about cigarettes? I did it. How about anything? It could be sex. Ooh, and y'all know we like that. Is you going to sacrifice or stop doing it all for God? Can you for real, for real? Can you for real, for real? What other scriptures did I read to y'all about the lusts of the flesh? Can you actually still be in love with somebody and you ain't having sex? Can you? Because we loving the wrong stuff. Is you loving that person as you loving the person in the bed? We talking about love, y'all. We talking about some stuff that you will have to sacrifice. Is you loving that person more than you loving God? Is you loving that house more than you love God? Is you loving that car more than you love God? Is you loving that job more than you love God? What are you going to sacrifice for him? Have you examined yourself lately? What is it that will we sacrifice just for God? For real. Oh, I can't. It just be so hard. I can't do this. It just be so hard. If somebody, let me tell you how the devil will try to tempt you and make something happen. And then you be like, oh, I need a cigarette so bad. Oh, I need a drink. Oh, you know what? Some of us drown ourselves in our sorrows by indulging. And it could be anything. I know this man who loved coffee so much you put him under the dirt. That man taught me everything I know. Because my father was here, he died when I was young. That grieved me. Coffee, y'all. Coffee. Tore up all his stomach. Until he had internal bleeding. Until he started throwing up, and you know how you bleed and the blood stay on your skin so long it turned brown? It had turned brown inside his body. Had been bleeding for years. Internally, slowly dying.
and not even knowing, because I couldn't even get the man to go to the doctor. Under the dirt. Us. What would we sacrifice? I used to always say, Pink, you gotta stop drinking all that coffee. That coffee gonna kill you. Not even knowing I hadn't even spoken. Half of the stuff that we go through in our own lives, we think we're doing something right. Well, he didn't drink. He didn't drink liquor. He not for cirrhosis of the liver, but he drunk on you, still dead. From overindulgence. It could even be in our mentality. Why do y'all think that Einstein was a lunatic? Because he studied too much. He did too much. Trying to obtain. So we try to obtain. And y'all think that it's just money, houses, cars. No, it's even books, knowledge. The Bible says, why seek so much knowledge and destroy yourself? The Bible says so. Not me. I didn't write this stuff. Then we think we know everything. And don't even know nothing. You're the biggest dummy in the world if you think you know everything. I'm telling you. What will we sacrifice for God? What will we sacrifice for him? That man was sacrificing his only son, the one that he loved, the one that he was promised. Will you even sacrifice your promise? Will you just for God? You ain't got to sacrifice your promise just for God if you being obedient concerning the promise. If you're being obedient. Because God promised this man. Come on, read.
And I would spake unto Abraham, his father, and said, my father. And he said, here I am, my son. And he said, behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering?
And he asked his daddy, what is you finna kill? Because he used to sacrifice it. He was brought up in the way. Come on, read.
And Abraham said, my son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering.
Even in the midst. He didn't want to tell that child, I'm going to kill you. He said, God will provide. He was even trusting God even then.
Jesus.
I know there's a reason, God.
My
you
God.
Want me to do this, but I just don't know why. God, you
Jesus.
Want me to sacrifice and walk away from that job. You want me to sacrifice and walk away from that man or that woman. You want me to sacrifice and walk away from the promise, God. You want me to do it, God. I may not understand why you want me to do it, God. But I'm going to trust and believe that whatever it is you want me to do, Jesus, I'm going to do it. And I'm going to trust that you will provide
me.
I'm going to believe right now. I'm activating that faith. That now faith.
Jesus. My
God. He knew without a shadow of a doubt. Right now. I know that God is going to provide.
My God.
Even though you questioning me about where is this and what is that. Even though you questioning me why I'm doing this and why I'm doing that. You may not understand my actions. And you may not even understand why I'm saying what I'm saying. But what you better know, without a shadow of a doubt, I believe that God is going to provide. I believe he's going to make a way. I believe he's going to fix that thing. I believe he's going to overturn that thing. I believe he's going to settle that thing. I believe he's going to move that thing back away. I believe right now that if I step into that water that I ain't going to drown. I believe that thing. I believe he's going to provide me air even if I go under the water. Oh, that's some kind of faith right there, baby, because you ain't no fish and you ain't got no fins. But I believe if he put me in there, he gonna bring me out. I believe that. I believe I ain't been going through this thing all this time and all these years for so long, but that it ain't a reason why. And I believe that he got a future for me. I believe it's an expected end. I believe it's a new chapter. I believe he already wrote that book that I have not even completed the end of yet. I believe it without a shadow of a doubt that even before I was born in my mama's womb, he knew me. I believe with everything in me. Come on, read.
So they went both of them together. And they came to the place which God had told of him.
See, when you get to believe in something and knowing it without a shadow of a doubt, it don't matter what you see, you're going to keep going. You're going to keep pressing. You're not going to stop
I don't care what situation it is. I don't care what's being done or what ain't being done. I don't care what's being said or what ain't being said. I do not give a rat's tail what it is. You gonna keep pressing because you know without a shadow of a doubt, you believe. Without a shadow of a doubt. So I couldn't cover your eyes up and you don't believe it because you know without that doubt. You may not see it, but you believe it. Read the book.
And Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order and bound Isaac his son and laid him on the altar upon the wood.
And he built that altar. Keep reading.
And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son.
And the Bible said
that the angel of the Lord called the son out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, here am I.
Hold it. Hold it. Oh, wait a minute. You done touched me. Because you was saying, kill your very son whom you love for me. I dare you to be obedient to God.
Jesus.
I will give a rest to him when it is.
My God.
I dare you to say yes, Lord, for you will and walk into your divine destiny. Not even knowing where you're going. I dare you to say, Lord, I'm going to leave that alone, God. Because I'm trusting and believing you're going to take that desire from me. And you're going to make it all right. I dare you today. What is you going to sacrifice to God? What would happen in the sacrifice? Come on.
And he said, lay not thine hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him.
Stop doing what you're doing.
For now I know that thou fearest God, seeing thou hast not withheld my son, thine only son.
That you believe me and you trust me because you ain't keeping nothing from me and you doing everything that I told you to do. And because of that, let me tell you what I'm going to do for you.
And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked. And behold, behind him, a ram caught in the thickest of his
God
bones. And Abraham went and took the ram
bed.
And offered him for a burnt offering instead of his
when
son.
When you think it ain't no plan. And when you think it is all lost. Come on, read.
And Abraham called the name of that place Jehovah Jireh, as it is said to this day. And the mouth of the Lord it shall be seen.
I dare you to trust God. Read.
And the angel of the Lord called and took
it,
Abraham
it goes a little
out of
than
the second time and said, by myself have I sworn, said the Lord,
because
thou hast done this thing and hast done not withheld thy son, thy only son, that in blessing I will bless thee. And in multiplying, I will multiply thy seed as the stars of the heaven and as the sand which is upon the seashore. And thy
seed
shall possess the gate of the enemy. And in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed. Because thou hast obeyed my voice. So Abraham returned to his young men.
Because you obeyed me.
Jesus.
Huh? Because you obeyed me. Huh? I rebuke emphysema and lung disease right now in the name of Jesus. I get a question. Listen to me when I sit up here and tell you. I dare you to do what God tells you to do. Sacrifice something for him. Sacrifice not being the way you normally be. Where he's trying to change you to be what he wants. I dare you to sacrifice not doing what you used to do. And how you used to do it for him. And watch what he do for you. I dare you not to take your old into your new. And watch God multiply what you got in your current. I dare. He said it, not me.
My God.
He said it, not me. God said it. He said that he would multiply what? Come on, read that part again. Come on,
Lord. That in blessings I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply.
He said, not where I will just bless you. In your blessing, I'm going to bless you. So that's a whole lot of blessings, y'all. He said, in your multiplying, I'm going to multiply. So it's just going to be an overall. And I've been hearing that for like the last 2 weeks. I've been hearing that. I've been getting phone calls. The Lord said, he's going to multiply. I was talking to the prophet and he said, no, the Lord said, listen to me. God said that he is doing. God said he'll do it because I'm like Abraham. He told me to come to a land that I didn't even know nothing about. I didn't even know where I was going to go or what I was going to do or how I was going to do it. That's how I landed up here today. I know what God said is true. Then in the midst of me doing everything that he told me to do, he told me that my wait was over. Everything that he promised me is right now. I embrace everything that God has for me. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. And even for you. Prophet, come up. Simeon. Minister Simeon, please. So, Jesus. Yeah, and it don't matter. I'm so tired of hurting. So tired of going through. I'm gonna hear from you, please. How you gonna go see? Come on, turn it up a little bit and start it from the top. And then just one part. Rewind. Hit it. Yeah. Listen. Would you trust God?
What if you call me and don't feel me near you, but you still trust me?
Y'all listening to me?
What if I tell you to let go
of the very thing
that you think you have to hold? Will you trust me?
Would you?
She does.
Yes. I'll trust you, Lord. What if it costs my life? Yes. I'll trust you, Lord. What if I lose with everything I love so dear? Yes. Somebody say, yes, I'll trust you, Lord. Somebody say, yes. Come on, put your hand up and say, yes, I'll trust you, Lord. I'll trust you.
And give me it.
So I'm going to ask everybody to come to the altar, please.